Hi, welcome to the channel NCRT Maths Tutor. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Exercise 10.3, Chapter 10 Straight Line, Question Number 3 Solution. Reduce the following equation into normal form. Find their perpendicular distances from the origin and angle between perpendicular and the positive axis. So here they have given 3 sub-questions. Before solving the problem, let us understand about the perpendicular distance from the origin. See, to find the distance of a point from a line, we have the equation d is equal to modulus of ax1 plus by1 plus c divided by square root of a square plus b square. So, this particular equation we can use. Suppose, let us say that there is an equation L and there is a point P somewhere on the xy plane with the coordinate x1 and y1. Now you want to know the distance between this point to this line. Then we can draw a perpendicular, and this perpendicular distance we can calculate by using this formula. So this formula we are using to find the distance of a point from a line. In the same way, we have a normal form. The normal form we can denote like this way: x cos omega plus y sin omega is equal to p. Here p is the perpendicular distance and omega is the angle made by the perpendicular with the positive x-axis. That is, suppose consider a Cartesian plane. Let us say that there is a line L. And here I have drawn a perpendicular from this line to the origin. Now this particular perpendicular distance, let us say that p. And this perpendicular makes an angle omega with the positive direction of the x-axis. Now here, this is nothing but the normal form representation. So here, see, if you compare this diagram with this one, both are similar only. Here we have a point P and we are finding the distance of this point to this line. And here you can take the point P as origin, that is 0, 0. And here also we are finding the distance from this point to here. So this particular P is nothing but D only. So by this, using this D formula, we can find out the P value here. But in this case, we already know the points, that is x1, y1, we can take as 0, 0. So in this particular equation, if you put x1, 0 and y1, 0, then we get a new equation, d is equal to modulus of c divided by square root of a square plus b square. That itself gives you the perpendicular distance from the origin. So we need to find out this particular value to find out the perpendicular. In the question, they have asked us to find out the perpendicular distance p as well as the omega. So P we can find out by this way. So that's why in this given sub question, first what I am doing is I am writing the values in the positive form of C. That means here we have x minus square root of 3y plus 8 is equal to 0. So this C we will written as it is, and the remaining values we will take to the another side. So that the C value is positive only, because here we know that we can get P value dividing this modulus of C divided by square root of A square plus B square. So first here I am finding the coefficient of x square plus coefficient of y square. That is, in this case, C minus x plus square root of 3y is equal to 8. Writing in this form is first of all very important. You have to maintain the positiveness of the C. So that's why I have kept this particular constant value here itself, and the remaining values I have taken to the another side. So we have here a square, that is coefficient of a x is minus 1 and coefficient of y is square root of 3. Substitute this value, square root of a square plus b square is equal to square root of minus 1 whole square plus square root of 3 whole square, that is equal to square root of 1 plus 3, that is equal to square root of 4, that is equal to 2. Now here we got this value, that is 2. Next here we know that the P is nothing but modulus of C divided by this one. That means already we have the C value C, that is 8, and if you divide this by 2, then we get the P value. So divide both sides by 2, that is minus x divided by 2 plus square root of 3 divided by 2 into y is equal to 8 divided by 2, that is minus half x plus square root of 3y, square root of 3 divided by 2y is equal to 4. Now this is nothing but our p value. So we got here the p value, that is the perpendicular distance from the origin. So p is equal to 4. Next here, we need to find out the omega value. See, to find the omega value, generally, if you compare this value with this particular equation, that is, then we can take this particular value as the cos value and this value as the sin value. So here we have cos omega, that is minus half, and sin omega is equal to square root of 3 divided by 2. So we have to find out an angle so that we have to get cos omega is equal to minus half and sin omega is equal to square root of 3 divided by 2. See, if you see 60 degree, that is cos 60 degree, we know that half and sin 60 degree is square root of 3 by 2. But we can't take here omega 60 degree, as here we have minus half. Cos 60 degree is plus half, but here we have minus half. So that's why now we have to find out an angle so that for cos as well as sin we have to get these values. So to find out an angle, we can use the quadrant rule. See, in this case, if you observe this cos and sin, here cos is negative and sin is positive. So now we have to find first the quadrant. See, in the case of quadrant rule, we have after school to college, first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. Cos is negative and sin is positive. We have to find out such quadrant. See, in the first quadrant, all are positive, so this is not possible. In the second quadrant, sin is positive, but cos is negative. That means, and whereas in the third quadrant, sin is negative as well as cos is negative, so this is not possible. In the fourth quadrant, cos is positive, but sin is negative, so this is not possible. That means, in this quadrant, sin is positive and cos is negative, so we can use here this quadrant, second quadrant. So in the second quadrant, now we have to write this 60 degree. How we can represent that? See, the second quadrant means you can use here 180 degree minus 60 degree. I can use here cos 90 degree plus 60 degree. But if you are using the 90 degree concept, then the conversion occurs. Cos becomes sin and sin becomes cos. But we don't want the conversion here. So that's why I will represent this 60 degree in terms of 180 minus theta. Because we know that cos 180 degree minus theta, that is allied angle property, cos 180 degree minus theta is nothing but minus cos theta. That is because, see, cos 180 degree minus theta means second quadrant, and in the second quadrant, the cos value is negative, so minus, and 180 degree we have, that means there is no conversion, so that is minus cos theta. In the same way, sin 180 degree minus theta means second quadrant, in the second quadrant, sin theta is positive and there is no conversion, so that is sin theta. So these two properties we can use now. So we have here minus cos 60 degree. This we can write as cos 180 degree minus 60 degree. See, cos 180 degree minus 60 degree is nothing but here theta we can take as 60 degree. So this is nothing but minus cos 60 degree only. So now 180 degree minus 60 degree is nothing but cos 120 degree. Then sin 60 degree we can write as sin 180 degree minus 60 degree. That is nothing but sin 120 degree. So here now we got two values, that is of cos and sin, that is theta is equal to 120 degree. For these two values we get here minus half for cos theta and square root of 3 by 2 for sin theta. So cos 180 degree minus 60 degree into x plus sin 180 degree minus 60 degree into y is equal to 4. That is, cos 120 degree into x plus sin 120 degree into y is equal to 4. You compare this particular value with this particular equation, then we can say that here omega value is equal to 120 and the perpendicular distance from the origin P is equal to 4. Next, question number 2, y minus 2 is equal to 0. So y minus 2 is equal to 0 we have. So first we have to represent this equation in such a way that we have to get the c value as always a positive. So that's why here we have minus 2, c is negative. So I'm taking this minus 2, the 2 to another side, so that we have y is equal to 2. But here we don't have x, so we can write that one as 0 into x, that is nothing but 0 only. 0 into x plus y is equal to 2. Now the first step is we need to find out the distance, that is the perpendicular distance from the origin, and for that formula is modulus of c divided by square root of a square plus b square. Here I have used just the c value, I have not used ax1 plus by 1, because we are finding the perpendicular distance from the origin, and for the origin the coordinates are 0 0, that means x1 is 0, y1 is 0, that's why this becomes 0. So I have used here just c. So now here we need to first find out the coefficient square. So square root of a square plus b square, that is here we have 0 square and here we have 1 square, that is equal to square root of 1, that is equal to 1. Now we got this value. Next here divide the c we have here 2, divide this 2 divide by 1 you have to perform so that we get the p value. So divide both sides by 1, that is 0x divided by 1 plus y divided by 1 is equal to 2 by 1. That is 0x plus y is equal to 2. So if you compare this with this, we get here p value. The p is nothing but 2 here. Next here, by comparing this with this, we can see that here cos omega is equal to 0 and sin omega is equal to 1. So now we have to find an angle so that we have to get cos omega is equal to 0 and sin omega is equal to 1. Such angle is 90 degree. We know that cos 90 degree is 0 and sin 90 degree is 1. So directly here we can get the answer. No need to do extra work as we did in the previous problem where we have to apply their quadrant rule. Here directly we can get the answer because we know that cos 90 degree and sin 90 degree has these values. So now compare this with this particular equation. We can say that omega is equal to 90 degree and the perpendicular distance from the origin p is equal to 2. Next sub question 3, x minus y is equal to 4. So now this is in the proper form. Here we have the c value as a positive. So directly you can find the coefficient. Square root of a square plus b square, that is 1 here. This here it is minus 1. So square root of 1 square plus minus 1 square, that is equal to square root of 1 plus 1, that is equal to square root of 2. So now here we got this value. Next here we have to find out the p value. The p is nothing but c divided by this. So here we got square root of 2, so 4 divided by square root of 2 you have to do, so divide both sides by square root of 2. So x divided by square root of 2 minus y divided by square root of 2 is equal to 4 divided by square root of 2. Here you can rationalize this value, that is 4 divided by square root of 2, as we have denominator value as square root. So rationalize square root of 2 into square root of 2, that you have to multiply, so that this becomes 4 into square root of 2 divided by square root of 2 whole square, that is 4 into square root of 2. This becomes 2. So 2 1s are 2 2s are 2 into square root of 2. So this value is after rationalizing we get here 2 into square root of 2. So now here we have the p value. We got the p value. The p is perpendicular distance from the origin, that is equal to 2 into square root of 2. Next here we have 1 by square root of 2 into x and here we have minus 1 by square root of 2 into y. If you compare this one with the normal form, that is cos omega x plus sin omega x, here the cos omega value, that is 1 by square root of 2, and the sin omega value is minus 1 by square root of 2. Actually for the 45 degree angle we get 1 by root 2 for cos theta as well as for the sin theta, but here we have a negative sign in the case of sin, so that's why we can't use that 45 degree angle directly. So now we have to apply the quadrant rule. See here, cos is positive and sin is negative, so first step is we have to find such quadrant where cos value should be positive and sin value should be negative. So let us see the quadrant rule. After school to college, here cos as well as sin both are positive. Here sin is positive and cos is negative, so this is not possible. Here cos and sin both are negative. Here cos is positive and sin is negative. That means we have to apply the fourth quadrant rule. So we need to do the process in the fourth quadrant. So in the fourth quadrant now, see again, we have to apply 360 degree minus 45 degree. We know that in the case of 360 degree, there is no conversion because in the place of cos, we need cos only. Here we need sin only. So that's why we can't apply 270 degree plus 45 degree concept. If you're applying that, then that is wrong. As here in this case, 90 degree as well as in the case of 270 degree, conversion take place. Cos becomes sin and sin become cos. So that's why I'm using here 360 degree minus 45 degree. See, 360 degree minus 45 degree is nothing but cos theta only, that is cos 45 degree only. We are applying here these two rule. Cos 360 degree minus theta is equal to cos theta, that is cos 360 degree minus theta means fourth quadrant. In the fourth quadrant here, cos is positive, so plus cos theta, and here there is no conversion. Then sin 360 degree minus theta, sin 360 degree minus theta, that means it is a fourth quadrant only. And then here we have the value, that is Here we can take that in the fourth quadrant, the sign is negative, so that is minus sine theta. So here these two rules we can apply in this case, so that minus sine 45 degree we can write as sine 360 degree minus 45 degree. So now we have here cos 360 degree minus 45 degree into x plus sine 360 degree minus 45 degree into y. That is equal to 2 into square root of 2. This is nothing but cos 315 degree into x plus sine 315 degree into y is equal to 2 square root of 2. Now here from this, if you compare this particular value with this equation, we can say that here omega value is equal to 315 degree and P, that is the perpendicular distance from the origin, is equal to 2 into square root of 2. Thanks for watching.